nasty skulkers. These sneaky, stabby little gobbos can bring big opportunities to the greenskins' table. Now, while Nasty Skulker's stats are not really anything to write home about, they've got some armor-piercing damage, which is nice on a cheap unit. Vanguard deployment is nice, but Stalk is incredibly powerful, teamed up with their ability Smoke Bomb, and this is really the key to Nasty Skulker power, because a minus 60% speed debuff is pretty damn huge. Their armor-piercing damage is just a nice bonus on top, really. Now, Nasty Skulkers want to be in the middle edges, really, of your formation behind the front line because they're not great at taking charges, but they can go out to help with cavalry if any comes around the flank, or they can stay ready if anyone dives in the middle of your army to try and get after perhaps your vulnerable lord. And this is where people and the AI will make mistakes, and they'll try to dive after your vulnerable lord. You then get the Nasty Skulkers on them, pin them in place with the smoke bomb so they can't get away, and jump on them with everything powerful you have. Ideally, try to save it for when the unit tries to run away or routes, so that you can grab it, stop it from getting away, and keep doing damage. This Moondragon might get away here, but with that Nasty Skulker smoke bomb, it ain't going nowhere and the boys can finish it off. Their high unit count and armor-piercing damage does also make them pretty handy against heavily armored cavalry. And naturally, they can stab up infantry as well. When it comes to campaign, just two or three units will probably suffice to use them for their smoke bomb, to catch that cavalry, those monsters, those lords. Because with Stalk, the enemy will never see them coming, and then you can jump all your powerful units on the smoke-bombed units and end them. So, sneaky, stabby, grabby boys for the greenskins that can offer a nasty surprise. That was Nasty Skulkers in 100 seconds. Coppers!